So why do we want to measure the traffic on the network? One reason might be billing. So for example, we might want to charge a customer based on how much traffic they've sent on the network. In order to do so, we need to passively measure how much traffic that customer is sending. Here's an example of measurements of inbound and outbound traffic volumes on a link on the Georgia Tech campus network. The y-axis is shown in bits per second, and the x-axis is the time of day. Now, a user might be billed based on how much traffic they send on the network. A common mode of billing is called 95th percentile billing, where a customer pays for what's called a committed information rate, or a CIR, and throughput is measured every 5 minutes. A customer then may be billed on the 95th percentile of these 5 minute samples. So if we were to bill on the 95th percentile of inbound traffic, we might approximate that 95th percentile by the orange line I've drawn here. And the customer might be billed at this rate, even though they're allowed to sometimes burst at higher rates. Another common reason to measure is security. For example, network operators may want to know the type of traffic that's being sent on the network so they can detect rogue behavior. A network operator may want to measure traffic on the network to detect compromised hosts or the presence of botnets or denial of service attacks, two phenomena that we'll talk about later on in the course. For the rest of this lesson, since we've focused a lot on performance measurement already, I will mainly focus on passive traffic data measurement.